welcome back to another video. I am Slips.
And you are?
Stash.
And you're watching Two Piece and a Biscuit. Today we're getting back into some more Ghosts. For any Ghost fans, we're doing He Is today. Dave seems pretty excited for this one.
I'm freaking excited.
I mean, Dave's been excited about every Ghost song, but this one he seemed just a little bit more excited about.
Because it's not everything else we've hit, man. When you hear this, you're going to be like, I could probably jam this in my car. But it sounds like an old... We'll just listen.
Okay. So, hopefully you guys have been enjoying all the reactions.
And to be honest, the video itself, like, kind of has a crazy meaning. Because I'm into all of the, I like true crime stuff.
Okay.
I like watching cult stuff. Mm-hmm. So, this is going to kind of rival on that. Okay. I'm going to see if you actually get it before I tell you what it's about.
I'm gonna try to.
But we'll see... We'll see if you get it. And most of the imagery itself is going to be in the video as far as the cult status of it goes.
Okay, cool.
So yeah.
Yeah, so let's hop into
I'm excited about this one.
He Is by Ghost. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe.
We're gonna sit down in the bottom. There's more Ghost songs to listen to.
Yep, let's do it.
Yup.
My first thought that I wanted to say is when I started the beginning, for some reason it reminded me, the way it sounded and the way he was singing, it reminded me of old Johnny Cash singing the Ring of Fire, and I don't know why. I heard the Ring of Fire when I heard the start of the song. I don't know why.
This song is a play on contemporary Christian music. You know how like they're trying to make a resurrection of Christian music and make it sound... It's kind of a play on it.
But
it sounds like a hymn.
Like a hymn,
would listen to like in church or whatever.
Yeah,
the entire thing's about Satan.
Oh, yeah, I definitely
see. Two star-crossed lovers reaching out to the beast with many names.
Two star-crossed lovers is the two.
Right.
Yeah.
To the beast with many names.
The
beast with many names is Satan himself.
Satan, the devil.
Right.
You know,
he is the shining of the light with whom I cannot see. He is insurrection. He is spite. He's the force that made me be. So basically, he is a worshiper.
He is the Nostra Despater, which I think I said was another.
Nostra Despater means the father of riches.
But it also says right here, it says, note the use of Nostra indicates a masculine perspective. Despater is also a name for a god of the underworld.
There you go.
So it also means the devil, god of the underworld.
Yeah.
And then Nostra. I got said the mother. What was that mother? The Nostra Alma Mater, which I said the our nurturing mother is
indicates how the devil is a fatherly figure to him, teaching him to make him grow.
We got genius lyrics pulled up.
Yep.
I'm not gonna, you know. I'm liking it. I mean, the sound, like you said, the sound of it.
Have you figured out who he's acting like yet?
No, I don't think so.
Have you ever heard of Jim Jones?
I've heard the name. Who's Jim Jones?
Jim Jones was a cult leader in the 70s and took all his people. He started in San Francisco, I didn't believe
was
it
was. Was he the guy that...
He was a preacher, and then he took everybody to Gahana in Africa.
Yeah.
And they had their own little cult thing set up, and a whole bunch of... they were saying, you know, there's people over here, you know, to the
he's United not the States one that made government. Them all like die, basically. Didn't
they drink the Kool-Aid. Yep. That's Jim Jones.
That's where the sayings don't drink the Kool-Aid.
That's it.
You know?
Don't drink the Kool-Aid.
I thought so. That's what
who he's acting like. He's got the sideburns and the
I've never seen him and stuff. So
yeah, the suits and. Once you watch this a little bit more, if you've ever watched a thing about Jim Jones, if you haven't,
I need to.
It's a crazy fucking story, the way these people got sucked into this shit.
Yeah.
He killed like 300 people.
Because I think I remember talking about it maybe in like English class or history class. At some point in time when I was in high school, Jim Jones got brought up. Not like a whole lesson.
A lot of people like compare Jim Jones to David Koresh, and that's some bullshit, because David Koresh was, he was a cult leader. I'll give you that, but like the reasons that they went over there to Gahana and the reasons that they went into Waco were two completely different reasons. Like, it's not, the two don't compare.
Right.
Like, I mean, Jim Jones thought he was, you know, the Word of God instead of David Koresh, and that's about all they had in common.
Right.
Besides the fact that David Koresh had sex with a whole bunch of women and fathered women from, or fathered children from a whole bunch of different women, but the government had no reason to go in to do what they did in Waco, but here they did because he was fucking just completely brain fucking everybody, like just sticking dicks in ears, he was fucking.
But yeah, like I said, I mean, if it wasn't for me, I think having my previous knowledge of ghosts being more like a satanic type message, I don't know if I would have gotten that. Like without now, if I knew what Nostra Despotter and all that, if I knew what that meant,
I mean, he used the insurrection and the spite.
Yeah, I mean, but I feel like if I would have listened though, I don't know if I would have like. Process that through my head without reading it. I don't know if I would necessarily
even from the beginning.
Yeah, I mean, I probably would have, but my mind
was standing in the abyss and the world was in flames. Two star-crossed lovers reaching out to the beast with many names. You wouldn't have caught that this is a satanic song.
I don't know. Sometimes,
you would. You probably wouldn't. You're a girl.
Sometimes. When you're riding around listening to music for the first time, you don't listen.
Yeah.
But when I'm sitting here with the lyrics in front
of me. But this is a jam, dude. I mean, the guitar is fucking beautiful, dude.
Oh, all of it is.
Like, it's amazing.
I love his voice. Yeah, he's got one of my favorite voices out of people we've done. I mean, I've said that about every band we've done almost with the voices. I mean,
Who's your favorite voice so far?
So far? I was about to say, we did a Megadeth. The Megadeth, that one's not one of my top ones because it's just, I liked Megadeth.
We got Alice in Chains.
I liked Alice in Chains.
We got Tool.
We got Maynard. We got Ghost. We've done a few other. We did the, what was it, the last new band you showed me?
No, Nothing More.
Nothing More.
Yeah. Fucking dude, his voice is amazing. He's got a range and a half. Dude.
And we did with Ozzy, the Black Sabbath.
Yeah.
Oh, that's rough. That's hard.
Yeah. It's rough, dude. It's rough.
I don't even know if I can pick, honestly. Because I got a couple songs where I would probably, I like Sober with Maynard singing that. I know every song so far from Ghost, I loved his voice on every song. I like them all. I don't know. I can't pick one. I can't pick. They're all number one. Fuck it. They're all number one. I ain't picking. But yeah,
I'm such a girl.
If I had to pick, I would probably say Maynard, maybe? Maybe.
I'll give it to you. He's got an amazing.
I've heard a lot more Tool, though. I'll give that to you than I have, like, Alice in Chains. I mean, we did Pantera. We've done Deftones as well.
Man.
I forgot about Deftones, too. Yeah. Man.
Oh, Chino.
Oh, woo! Man. We haven't done as much as somebody like Alice in Chains, because I know you said that, you know, he's your favorite vocalist, Link Staley.
We gotta hit some more of them.
So I can't compare, but we've done 10 songs to Tool, but... All right, let's get back into the rest of this. I'm going on way too much about vocalists and singing and all that.
There's no such thing as too much.
Too much, you're right.
That's maybe we should be cult priests.
We're turning off the video right now. We're becoming cult priests.
Yeah, we're gonna start our own cult now. Jared Leto did it.
Yeah.
From 30 Seconds to Mars, he's got a cult.
Does he really?
Yeah, he really does. Yeah, yeah. It's like all over the fucking place. He takes people to, I think it's Italy or something.
Cults
like
are so
that.
Weird.
And they go out there and they fucking walk around. And he walks around in Jesus robes all day.
Super dope song. The video, like Dave's talking about, like I said, I knew who Jim Jones was, but I didn't know what he looked like or all that. But like you said, he's literally got these women, like Dave was saying, baptizing them in these white shirts and the water, you know, grabbing full on cup of titty, just a full on
booby.
Cup of booby. I mean, nothing wrong with grabbing a booby, but that's kind of too far though, having a cult to do that, you know.
We're starting one.
I guess that's what we're doing.
Two piece in a cult.
What you guys didn't know...
Two cults and a biscuit.
Well, see, what they didn't know, Dave, is this is already a cult. They didn't realize that they're already following
it
us.
Is.
We just gave it away.
Damn it.
That's unfortunate. Really good song. Like I said, his voice, I don't even know how to explain it. It's almost like he's so boisterous. Like, he's so, like... He's always at, like, that top range when he's singing.
Yeah, he's into everything he does, man. Like, I mean, you could tell he feels what he's talking about.
Right.
Even if he's not a true Satanist, and this is just, you know, a joke band.
Like, it's kind of like,
You can tell he's got feeling behind his lyrics.
Right.
And I love it.
It's kind of like, not that it has to do with Satanism, it's kind of like, you know, like, say someone like Eminem and rap, who raps about crazy outlandish shit, but doesn't really mean, he says he's going to kill you, but he's not really about to come and kill you. He's speaking about Satanism and stuff, but... Is he a Satanist? Probably not. I don't know Tobias personally to know whether or not he's. I don't know Tobias well enough to know whether or not he is a Satanist or not. But it doesn't mean you can't speak on things or tell a story and just, you know, prove a message. You know, I don't know. I've not seen enough interviews from people who've ever asked him, "Hey, are you a Satanist?" I don't know.
Oh, there's a few videos out there.
I'd have to watch them. He seems like an interesting guy overall,
yeah, he does.
From what I've seen
really
from him.
Does.
You know, like I said, he looks nothing, of course, but he's got all that. I love the makeup. I think it looks so cool with his makeup.
Yeah, it does. I wanted to do it for Halloween this year, but I knew my daughter wouldn't get up early enough to fucking do my makeup.
Do it for you.
I would have done the full Tobias makeup with the ears on.
Oh, yeah, that'd be cool. Yeah,
that would be awesome. That would have been great. That's Skull Bunny.
But hopefully you guys enjoyed. Hopefully we got some Ghost fans out there and we can bring you guys along. Check out our Rock Reaction playlist for other Tool, Megadeth, like we said, Pantera. Oh, actually, Pantera's not on there. I lied.
Nope.
Alice in Chains.
The Pantera got blocked. Just like
Jimi Hendrix got blocked.
Jimmy got blocked. I don't understand. Everybody else does Jimmy. Why can't we do Jimmy?
I don't think we're cutting it
off. I think they're biased against us. I think they hate us because we're so
awesome. As Jack Black said it, we need to stick it to the man. With rock and roll.
That's what I do.
Rock and roll.
I stick it to the man. I get in trouble for it, though.
But hey, stick it to the man. It don't matter whether you lose your job, get fired.
I don't give a
shit. I don't
give a damn. Give a fuck.
Stick it to the man.
Stick it to him.
So if you enjoyed, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. We'll see you guys in the next one.
Hit us down in the comments. Let us know what other ghost songs you want to hear or whatever other songs you want to hear. Somebody hit us with some Avatar. Down to do some Avatar. We're going to hit that shit up. Probably not this 2 weeks, but the next 2 weeks, I'll find some good Avatar and we'll introduce Cody to some Avatar because that's a good shit.
So, like, comment, subscribe.
Hit us down.
We are Two Piece and a Biscuit.
Deuces!